I'm champ of the world. You know what I mean? I'm still at the stage. What am I going to be when I grow up?
I'm going to be like him. I'm going to be like him. I'm going to be like him.
Boxing always has its share of female followers.
I'm not here.
I used to always say, no girls like me. I said, no girls like me, I'm ugly. Cuts never said, he never stroked my ego, said, wait, you're a nice looking guy. He said, in a few years, I don't care how ugly you think you are, whatever, I'm going to buy you a bat and you're going to have to beat all the girls off.
Fall in love. People argue, people make love, that's just how life is. We're very normal and very much in love.
Me and my wife will always be together. I'm always gonna have my wife will always have me. If I never had a penny, if we're broke, we're together. Those are our vows.
History has said that athletes get whipped off. I just don't want it to happen to Michael.
I just don't want it to happen to Michael. I just don't want it to happen to Michael.
Givens called police to the couple's home this weekend, claiming that the champ had threatened her and her mother.
He's manic and he's incredibly abusive, not physically, verbally.
The soap opera marriage of boxing champ Mike Tyson and actress Robin Givens is coming to an end.
I felt a sense of abandonment, but I brought it on to myself. I felt alone. I felt a little ashamed. I felt like a half of a person. I didn't feel totally whole at the time.
I was those Japanese girls like it was like it was eating grapes. You thought I was Caesar. You thought I was Caligula when I was out there in Japan, you know?
They say, do you think a blessing in disguise?
You're coming into my house, and I will skillfully and tactfully tear you down. Because when I walk into the arena, it's on.
But real life proved less simple. 6 weeks after Tyson married actress Robin Givens in February of 1988, Jacobs died of leukemia at 58. Over the next 3 months, the champ's relationship with Caton dissolved while his life at home grew stormy. That June, the champ unloaded his frustrations in Atlantic City's convention hall.
And he's down again, and in. 6, 7, 8.
He's not going to make it. 10. It's all over.
After he knocked out Michael Spinks in 91 seconds, that was as good as he got.
That was the last night that Kevin Rooney was his trainer. Rooney used to kiss him goodbye. That was the last kiss goodbye.
There's this huge void in Tyson's life. When Jacobs died, okay, you've got Don King swooping in like a vulture to take over.
And from that point on, what little semblance of order was in his life was over. Kevin Rooney was out. Caton was out. And then his wife and mother-in-law kind of moved in, and this sorry soap opera began.
Robin changed things. In fact, almost as soon as they was married, she called to say, I'm Mrs. Mike Tyson and I'm taking over. She actually had the nerve to say that.
With Caton and Rooney gone and Tyson's domestic beatings played out in headlines, he's spun out of control.
The Mike Tyson story started on Sunday when his car hit a tree near his upstate New York training camp. Tyson was knocked unconscious for almost a half hour.
Mike goes around crying out for help. And the way that he does it, driving cars into trees, you know, beating up people, even things as hideous as rapes and assaults, are almost Mike Tyson's way of declaring emotional bankruptcy. I can't deal with life. I can't take care of myself. You know, here, take care of me. Take me somewhere.
During an interview with Barbara Walters in September of 1988, Tyson sat quietly while his wife provided to millions a window into their private life.
Michael is a manic depressive. He is. I mean, that's just a fact. He's got a side to him that's scary. Michael is intimidating, to say the least.
He shakes, he pushes, he swings.
And see, there was something horrific about him being sedated on that television show and her sitting there talking about him like he was some trained bear.
The interview sent him into that rage when Mike was tossing furniture around and where the police had to be called to their home in New Jersey, and Ruth and Robin had to run for their own safety.
A week later, Givens filed for divorce.
I won't talk nice to you and talk about fornicating with you and letting you suck my because if I was eloquent with you, you would still look at me as a scumbag. It won't work. You have your perception of me.